space and get you the results that you need and results that people can understand. And that's how I would describe this product, elegant simplicity, because there's only two ingredients. Black tea extract, which acts as kind of like a base of a beverage. Now, black tea by itself has health benefits, but really what I'm going to focus my talk about tonight, in the interest of abbreviated time, is African mango seed extract. African mango is different from the mangoes that you buy in the grocery store, because African mango has inside of it a seed, which actually is better described as being a nut. And in African cuisine, that nut is ground up and used in many, many different types of food, including a soup that, forgive me if I pronounce this wrong, it's Ogbono soup, as a thickener, as a porridge. It's a very great source of protein and carbohydrates. Now, the story gets a little foggy here, but the point is that somebody, some scientist, I assume it's a traveling scientist who's eating in a restaurant in West Africa, noticed that people who ate a lot of African mango in their diet had favorable metabolic parameters. And that is, they had good cardiovascular health, they had control of their blood sugar, and they were thin. And they thought, wow, I gotta do something with this. When I get back home, I gotta do an experiment. And so they did an experiment with a crude extract of this African mango seed, and they took that extract and put it on some mouse fat cells. And what they discovered was very interesting. They discovered that the fat cells did not reproduce. They did not multiply. Then they started doing more studies with more refined extracts, and eventually it led up to a major human controlled clinical study, which I'm going to present the data on tonight. Let's go back to the mouse fat cell study. I think everyone knows from high school biology that all the cells in your body, nearly all of the cells in your body, turn over. The old ones die, they're replaced with young, new cells. Well, fat cells are no different. About 8% of your fat cells annually are turned over and replaced with new cells. And that process is diagrammed here on that screen. It's basically a multi-step process, but what I want to point out to you is this last step, where you're going from what's called a pre-adipocyte, like a baby fat cell, to a mature adipocyte, mature fat cell, it involves something called PPAR gamma. And that's just a chemical, a factor that's needed for maturation of the fat cell to occur. Well, it turns out that African mango seed extract inhibits PPAR gamma and prevents this last step from occurring. And therefore, if you're a regular consumer and user of African mango extract, those 8% of fat cells that are being turned over your body each year, they ain't going nowhere. They won't produce, they won't mature. I'm not saying it kills fat cells, I'm saying the new fat cells will not mature and develop. And who wants more fat cells? I don't think anyone does, do they? Hey, if you look, you're gonna find a lot of African mango extracts on the marketplace today, but there is only one authentic African mango extract called Welltrim, and referred to in the studies as IGOB 131. But Welltrim is the trade name. It is a certified, it's authentic, it's safe, it's been patented. I encourage you to look up the patent. It's really just go US patent number, blah, 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 and you'll pull up the patent instantly on Google. It's been clinically studied in a double-blind placebo-controlled study, and it targets multiple metabolic pathways involved in weight management. That's what makes it so special. It's very much analogous to pycnogenol. There's a lot of pine bark extracts out there, but there's only one pycnogenol.
That's right.
That's right. Let's hear it for pycnogenol. All right, we're talking about fat. So, what's wrong with fat? Yeah, it takes up some space. It makes me weigh a few pounds more. But what's the problem with it? Yeah, I hear these studies that says if I'm obese, then I got maybe I'm much more likely to die prematurely. I'm much more likely to have a heart attack. I might have type 2 diabetes, but why? Why does that happen when you get fat? Well, it turns out that fat just doesn't sit there. Fat is biologically active. And what that means is that fat, especially a type of fat called visceral fat, and that's the fat that's inside your body, that's surrounding your organs. Visceral fat especially is involved in giving you insulin resistance, giving you high blood pressure, giving you high triglycerides. So it's biologically active, this fat, and it's producing chemicals and substances. And depending upon how well-behaved or misbehaved those chemical substances are, it can wreak havoc on your health.